All right, everybody. Welcome back to more World 1-1 Plays Metroid Prime 2 Echoes. We're picking up exactly where we left off last time. I know it's been a hot minute, and I've actually been itching to get back to this. Just kind of had a whole bunch of shit going on, but we get there eventually, always. So, picking up where we left off, we just got ourselves into the Sanctuary Fortress. I've actually had the GameCube running the whole time, so we've got this little notice here at the top of our screen telling us to get our asses to the temple. So, let's get over there and see what's cracking. As you recall, we met some new friends last time. Like this guy here, the Resbit. I'm actually going to let him hit me because he does really cool shit. Come on. Take a shot. No, not that thing. Do the other cool thing. No. Oh, come on. Alright, apparently he's not going to do it. But the Resbits do this really cool thing. There he goes. Watch. Yeah, that's not a glitch. They've actually infected our power suit. You've got to hit the little combo of buttons there to reboot your power suit software to get the hell out of it. I always thought that was really fucking neat. Alright, we're going to knock them out, because they have done entirely too much damage. We're going to swing back to the save station here and recharge real quick, and then we'll go bugger on our way. Alright, so let's start by seeing what's over on this side of the room. Alright, we got a big locked door that we can't get in yet. Some boxes, we can try and pick up some more ammo. Hey, there we go. Good. Now we're going to scan these things. Yep, they're not going to do anything for us. That's okay, whatever. Alright, and that's the thing we can't do anything with yet. I love just the visual aesthetic of the whole place. The whole holograms and the walls and everything. And I don't know, it appeals to the nerd in me. There we go. Alright. Can't get that door, so we're gonna go this way. Alright, so we need Amber, Cobalt, Crimson, Emerald. Wander around here. Alright, so we've got Amber first. And then we go find Cobalt. Blue. And then Crimson is red. And Emerald is green. Now we've got them all locked down, so we have a nice pathway across. Ta-da, we did it. Go us. Oh, look at that big guy. He looks fun and exciting, doesn't he? All right, we got another quad up here. Probably just ignore him, honestly. He ain't doing nothing. And we find ourselves with a Dark World portal. So we're going to hop across and see what's on the other side. And we have arrived at now the Ing Hive, which is the Dark World version of Sanctuary Fortress. Hey, look, we found a key. Can't get to it yet, but we found it. Cool. Got one. Let's start poking around. Alright, let's pop those open and see if we can grab some light ammo here. Be super helpful. Really? Damn near nothing? Oh well. Alright. Turn on the elevator and up we go. We'll see what's up here. Got a bunch of night barbs over there. Definitely need to do something about these. If you'll notice, those dots up there, those are useful. We're going to need those in a minute. I know this part is just kind of painfully slow. But man, we got a lot of missiles. Oh, no, that is not what I thought it was. Okay. Whee! Alright. So we got a portal, but it's behind a force field. And now they've respawned again. Those are the buttons we were looking for. Okay. Now we've gotten rid of those. We can use our dark visor, and then these dots all become targetable by way of seeker missiles. And that will turn off the force field, so we have a way back to the light world. Before we go back, we're going to keep poking around. Got him. Alright, so here's another door that we have nothing to open it with yet. So that's going to dead end us. We'll head back. I don't know why I put that away. We're going to need that in a second. Make our way back over to the light world. And we're back. Now we are totally disconnected from where we were, which was down there. That's okay. We've gone up, which is the general direction we needed to go. Alright, we got broken bits all over the place here. Oh, those are springing to life. Alright, we got one. I'm gonna take him out. Got one down. I don't know if I even care enough. So these look terribly familiar, don't they? Remember these annoying little bastards from Magmore Caverns in Prime. Let's give them a scan, though. Alright, so we have Mechlops. So they're basically just mech versions of the little Triclops bastards from Prime that generally just got in our way. They're both over there busy, so we'll make our way through. And there we go. Ooh, static. There we go. Get him out of there. Alright, so we got security doors. We've got an elevator. And a big reactor looking thing. There we go. Scan the rings. Okay, so obviously something we can't interact with yet. We have an echo key beam system. But we need a sonic detection gear in order to do anything with it. Yep, we're not getting in there yet. We'll go back up the elevator. Alright, now we can snake our way around the side of the room like this. Cool. And now we've got a bomb slot to play with. Alright, so bomb slot turns on a puzzle. So let's puzzle out the puzzle. Ah, we've done it wrong. There we go. Now we've puzzled the puzzle. Gives us the other bomb slot. Now there's a door over there with a missile cap on it. Take that off in a minute, too. Cool. Now we've stopped one of the rings. Poke that door open. See what's in there real quick. Hey, look, we found a save station. This might be my favorite save station of the whole game. This view is just awesome. Look at that draw distance. That's just spectacular. Alright, so now that we stop the outside ring, we've got a platform we can wander across. So let's wander across and see what's on the other side. More morph ball action, cool. and it gets us to the other side of the security door. So let's go ahead and open this up, so that way we have a shortcut going forward. Turn on this other elevator that'll take us up instead of down to the bottom of the room. Alright, so I got some stuff up here. Don't think we can do anything with the stuff. Yep, no, we can't do anything with the stuff yet. So let's hop through the door and see what's in here. Ah, okay, so we've got some hidden targets. So we'll pop... Ah! That was terrible. How did we miss that? That's better. And down we go. And now we've got an orb to use. Best kill of the game. So glad that is forever recorded for posterity now. No, we've gone backwards. That's not where we wanted to go. Alright, so, lots of stuff happening in here. Whee! Down we go. Ooh, they're all about to get infected! Alright, so now we've got dark quads. Two scans each. I honestly don't feel like messing with them, so we're just going to see what we can do to ignore them and make our way up the room without having to hassle with them. They really want our attention, though, don't they? Alright, double grapple. Get our Tarzan on. Bam! Look at that. Smooth as butter. And here we are. The Sanctuary Fortress Temple, right where we're supposed to be. Here are the words of Olir, last sentinel of the Fortress Temple. May they serve you well. This used to be a great fortress, a safe haven for our people during the war. It also holds portals to the Ing Hive, the heart of their dark tribe. During the war, I built a number of mechanical sentinels to join me in battle. They were made to fight the Ing, and fight them they did for a time. One by one, the Ing corrupted them. Now they attack with no mercy. Many went to Dark Aether with their Ing masters. Expect them when you are in the Hive. The Ing like to use them as guards. The Ing will protect their home with great ferocity. In all of our battles, the Hive has never fallen. I've updated your translator module. You can access devices and doors coated with cobalt holograms. Search the areas now opened to you. If only I could join you, redeem my fallen honor in battle, but my time has passed. Good luck. Let the light of Aether show you the way. Sparkle fingers. Alright, so we got a health refill. And we got an update to our translator, so now we can open and use the blue holograms. Like that one. Alright, I'm going to pause here for a minute because I got something going on upstairs I got to take care of for just a moment, and then we'll be right back. Alright, let's get back to it. So, we got our translator module, so now we can start digging deep into the Sanctuary Fortress. Obviously, there are roadblocks we're going to hit that are going to have us kind of bouncing around to some other places still. So, no way across there. We can get across here, though, and into this door. Fun, cool ass room. Alright, so let's see if there's anything we're missing here to get ourselves across. Ooh, those are scannable. Grab one of those. Come back here. Aww. You're running away. Ooh, that's a thing. Well, there he is. Let's go get a scan. Yeah, we're just going to fall. Bugger. Alright, so we've now got a morph ball cannon. It'll shoot us across the way here. Because this is the way. There's another cannon. It'll let us get back. Scan him. Alright, so we've got the Spider Guardian. This is actually the only place you can scan him. Because now we're in the fight, and we're going to be in the morph ball for this whole fight, which means no way to scan him except for that one little spot right up front before. I found that this is much easier if we are zoomed out, because I can get a better angle on the bomb jumps. Alright, so we've slowed him down, and we've kicked on this bomb slot. We're going to get over here, jump up, hit the bomb slot. And that's going to push him into the first little reactor. I'm going to follow him over and see what he does. Alright. So this gets a little tricky. Now we've got to hit him with our bombs mid-flight, basically. Thank you. Fun fact, outside of the Boost Guardian, this is generally considered one of the most, the other, like, most difficult boss fight of the entire game. Alright, so now we've pissed him off. Now we gotta hit him again. Damn it. All right, we're going to try and get him on the pass here. There we go. Now we got him. All right, let's get him again. Now we're on a bit of a timer. We're gonna sneak up here. There we go, we got it. Notice how much health this dude takes out. So even though he's a modified pill bug, he is not to be trifled with. Zoom out so we can see what we're doing here. Alright. Get him there. Get him on the pass down. Shit. Alright. I think this is going to be our opportunity right there. Now we got him. We just get the hell out of the way. Let him fry himself. Now we chase him. Alright, here's our only godsend, is we're going to pick up some health while we're here. Alright, we got a little bit of a health boost. Alright, here's where things get funky. Get him there, kick on the bomb slot. Get number one. So this is our safety spot to work it out. Alright, so. Crap. Alright, we got a boost across. Let him pass up here. Now we're on a timer. Get this next one. Get him to make that run into the next reactor. Alright. We got one more to go. And this is the tough one, because now we gotta hit all three.
shit.
That's slot number one. I don't think we're going to get it. No, we're not. Well, we might get it. No, we missed it. And we're going to take the hit. Slot number two. Shit. Okay. Got him going the right direction here, so that's good. Basically, we want to time this so we can buy ourselves as much time as humanly possible. Ah! Getting that. We gotta wait for him to pass back across the door. Whew, just right. Damn it. We got him stalled. No. We may actually take an L on this one. Oh, I think we got it. We got him. Woo. I thought we were going to have to redo that. Holy shit. Got it and won. Go us. Go Team World 1-1. Alright, pick up that awesome health. Thank God. And claim our prize! And now we've got the spider ball. All right, so we got a dead end door here. But now we can make use of all these lovely spider ball tracks that we couldn't before. That's great news for us. A spider ball usage in Prime 2 is actually considerably cooler than it was in Prime 1. And we score some missiles. We poke around the right way. There we go. Because there's now an added item combo here. Do a quick demonstration. So we're going to spider ball ourselves here, and we can charge our boost ball. We can use that to launch ourselves off the spider ball track. So we've actually been in that door. We want to go through this door now. Now that we can spider-ball our way up and reach it. Alright, so we got some more key-bearer lore. That's a cool-looking contraption, isn't it? Alright, we're going to turn on this elevator here. Grab some more lore, and now we can scan the spider ball track for a research entry. Well, there's a door over there we haven't touched yet. Let's go touch that door. Oh look, he's waking up! Say hello to an Ing Smasher! Ooh, we can't get to that door yet. That's why we haven't touched that door. Alright, we're gonna wander away from him. Actually, I think we can shortcut across. Yes, we can. Now we have the spider ball. And save point for the health. And now we can see what's in this door. Now we have the translator. Yeah, it's a big beam of light and a map. Look at that.
This is huge. He's going to throw an infection at us. Do it again. Spooky blue sparklies and ominous music. That could only mean one thing. Oh, we found our friend! He just wants to play. And now our bridge is broken. That could be a problem. You think? I feel like that could maybe be a problem. Alright, so we can't break that. We do have this handy dandy spider ball track that we now have a spider ball to go with. That boost ball thing I was telling you about is great for spots like right there. Now we can still get across. So our next stop is actually going to take us out of the Sanctuary Fortress and all the way back to Torvis. That off. All right, so we gotta find our way over to Torvis. That's Aegon, that's not where we're headed. So best route is gonna be shortcut across the top here then and get ourselves over there. Got it. Bye-bye. All right, elevator up. Sorry about the audio clipping. There we go. Alright. I don't remember which one takes us to Torvis, but I think it was this one? Might be this one. Yeah, I don't know what the hell is going on with my OBS here, but it's struggling. So I apologize about the audio clipping. Ooh, it's getting framey too. Okay, I think it's catching up. Got the right one. Alright, so we're just going to ignore the shit out of them. They're 100% unimportant. Get out of my way. Nobody likes you. In we go. We'll take the shortcut across this room here. And on our way back to Torvis. So I may be cheating slightly because I know where we're headed next. And if you've been taking notes, you'd know where we're headed next. But to be fair, it's not the most super obvious thing either. So, but it'll all make sense when you see it. But we're heading all the way down to the bottom of Lower Torvis. So, yeah, that way. Because, let's be honest here, it's not a Metroid game without backtracking. It's kind of what it's meant to be. There we go. Alright, we're gonna wing up and grab that save point. Man, totally mistimed that jump. There we go. Now we are heading down all the way to the bottom. So you might remember there was a portal over here we couldn't really do much of anything with, just kind of dead-ended us. Now we're headed there. There's also something down in this room where we fought the Alpha Blog that we couldn't do anything with yet. But again, it was kind of discreet and buried behind all the murk of the water. And that was the Spider Ball track. And now that we have the Spider Ball, we can make our way up this track to this portal. And now we've got this big ugly thing up here. And it's a boss fight. Specifically, it is a guardian fight. And it is the power bomb guardian. So we're going to grab that scan. Got him. I think we can scan that. Yeah, we can scan those, can't we? Maybe. They kind of look scannable. Nope, they're not. All right. So, what we need to do is spider ball our way up here and start hitting these bomb slots without getting taken out by the power bombs that he's throwing at us. Got the next one. Good. This isn't a terribly difficult fight for what it's worth, but it is neat. I love that Echoes did so much more with the Morph Ball and the Spider Ball than Prime did. Okay, we've got to back off there. Now he's throwing preemptively. Oh, damn it. Took us down. And that'll be the last one. Release all the clamps. And squish. Okay. So, now there's a new scannable that we haven't come across yet. But again, it's something we can't do anything with just yet. But that will change. Okay, now the bridge is down. I'm gonna jump over here and get our power bombs, aka pocket nukes. means now we have the equipment to pop open these yellow door caps. And it's about bloody time. Take out all the shrimp. I do think, too, the power bomb refills are much more identifiable here than they were in Prime. The redesign, I think, was a good choice. Now we can actually go through there, too. So let's go back down and let's get into the ring. So many fishies in the sea. So many fishies, but no one for me. There we go. That's the thing I was looking for. Get us the hell out of the water. Land us here, and we can now kick on this bomb slot. So move this big honking statue. Now we can get behind the statue and get these missiles. Woohoo, missiles! Then up the door. Oh, look, scannable platforms. Oop, there's a blog in there. That's okay. And now this elevator will take us straight back to Sanctuary Fortress without us having to cut across the temple grounds. Yay, hell. Smoking gun. And pop the power bomb lid. And we have arrived back at the Sanctuary Fortress. Just a couple rooms off of someplace we've already been. But also in new territory. Which is also awesome. We're going to spiderball our way up here where it's safe. Take a look at this big thing. We'll circle back to that eventually. There we go. Okay, so that's breakable with a power bomb, but we are fresh out at the moment. So we're going to go ahead and just move right along here. Oh, look! Now we have a power bomb. Let's break it. We can make a jump through that portal. This whole double room puzzle is a little weird and convoluted. But there is a reward at the end of it. Uh-oh. Now we've got a dark ink smasher on our hands. Start taking them out. Oh, he switched on us. We need that dark beam. They're pumping them full of ammo. And he's down. We got him. And our reward is 20 health. There. That's where we broke in. So we need to portal out here. Portal back through here. Spider ball up this track. So now we've got high ground. Portal across again. Told you, lots of back and forthing in this room. It's really weird. And that'll get us our first power bomb expansion. Now we can hold 3 instead of 2. Hooray! Drop out of there. And to the right. Bust open the door. And look, Resbit's here to greet us. Bye-bye, Resbit. Oh, that's right. There's more res bits in here, aren't there? Ooh, we got a shield up. Sneaky bastard. Alright, let's take out this last one. Get behind a shield. And claim our missiles. Now that we've got this fancy spider ball, we can also start making our way up this. If we avoid the electric shocky thing happening. Alright, up we go. Now these little dots here are going to give us clues as to where to sit and boost ball across. Crap. Damn it. Sit here and wait for a second. All right. There, we made it. That scores us a fresh energy tank. It's been a while since we've seen one of those, actually. So good for us. So we're going to head... Am I thinking we're in the right direction here? No, we want to go that way. Alright, so other side of the room. Get across the security rings again. There we go, super easy. And now, we can get to this other door because we can power bomb out in a nice homage to Super Metroid, that tunnel there. Totally ignoring him. And now we have a shortcut to the Aegon Wastes. Except we have no power bombs to open that door with. It's kind of a shame because there's actually a bunch of stuff in the Aegon Waste we could be picking up now that we've got some new equipment. This is a really cool room, too. The whole glass floor thing. You know, look down and look out. I think is really neat. I love the aesthetic design of everything in the Sanctuary Fortress. Come on, open up. There we go. Oh, he's taking a swing. I kind of wish I had the option to like get in and play with some Ink Smasher armor. I think these guys are really neat. Solidly one of the best designed enemies of the game. Well, look, there's another one, but I don't think we're gonna mess with him right now. Plus, we're real thin on dark beam ammo, and you kind of need a solid supply of both to take him on. But now we've got our power bomb, so we can go back to the waste and open up that door and get in there. Look, pill bugs. We've been here before. Oh, good. I got one of them to drop a power bomb for me. Alright, now there is an upgrade in here somewhere. There we go. And there it is. Scored some missiles. We're heading in the right spot. Wanted to make sure. All right, so not that door, but we want to... make our way over here. Other side of the room from where we came in. Dark beam that open. Some pill bugs. Let's see if we can catch some solid refills off any of these. Probably not. Oh, there's some health. Not what I was in desperate need of, but I'll take it. And now we've got a real close quarters seeker door to open. There we go. Alright, turn the cannon on. So that'll give us our way out. Alright, so we're going to power bomb that open. That finds us a secret hidden door. And that secret hidden door scores us some missiles. Fantastic. Not bad, not bad. Just taking a look around, making sure we're not missing anything here. Alright, we got another orb cannon. Gonna toss us all the way up here. We can score some lore. Also scan the big drilling contraption. Go ahead and hit this bomb slot and see what it does for us. Oh, look, it makes it go up and down. Up and down. Yeah. There we go. And that lands us right here in the middle of this drill thingy. Oh, look, there's a bomb slot. Oh, and a body. Does the body matter? The body might matter. Body doesn't matter. Alright, we're on a timer. That means... get out of there. Alright, so we got it spinning. Can we get it up and down? Up and down! We got the up and down! There we go! Now, it's going to be stuck in a raised position, so we're going to need to make our way back through this pipe so we can get back onto the drill blades. And here we are. And that now gives us access to a new portal. Power bomb. Grab that.
And that one.
Alright, so now we got a solid refill on our dark beam ammo that we were starting to run real thin on. Start taking out these night barbs. Let's get a look at the room here. Okay. Clearly, this is a super friendly place to be. Where we came in. What I think we want is to find our way up there. We gotta find a platform conducive to that first. Like this. That's conducive. Kind of leads us nowhere. Oh, we can make that jump. There we go. Those open for some light ammo. And now this will get us behind the gate that we couldn't get at the very beginning of the Aegon Waste, actually. Now we can go play back here. That scores us our first beam ammo combo. The Dark Burst. Which I really think is a very cool combo. This thing literally creates a fucking black hole. And now we're gonna take it out for a spin. It's insanely expensive, but God, is it cool. It's like, black hole, I eat you all. So, a very roundabout trip to get what we were after, but we've totally got it. And now we are even more heavily armed. We're going the wrong way. Other side.
Okay.
We're going to go to the left. Really? Apparently I can't make a jump to save my life. I'm also apparently getting stuck on invisible shit. Which, you know, is just super unhelpful. Alright. That's enough. Done playing with y'all. There. Oh. Okay. Head off to the right here. I totally ignore them. They're absolutely uninteresting to me. Bye bye. Well, that sounds encouraging, doesn't it? Alright, so the Talon Metroids here are going to be susceptible to the Dark Beam very much like it was the Ice Beam from Prime 1. So, easy enough, not a big deal. We're going to roll up, grab our missiles. Be real, we all knew that's what was in here. I don't care. Doors. There we go. Come on, let's trip him and get him close. There we go. That's better. Now then. Turn those platforms back on.
And we're going to make our way up this sneaky little spider ball track. Ah! Nuts! Go. Bolt across. Got it. Okay, I missed something here. I don't remember what it is that I missed. But it's something. That's what it is. I needed that center spider ball. Okay, now I know what the hell we're doing. Should have gone with my gut. My gut said take that one and boost off it. No, not that one. Not far enough. There it is. Alright, it's a long shot. Ah! We actually missed it. Holy hell, what the fuck? Alright, last time, I swear. It's gotta be it. That's enough. All right. I think I'm going to pause it and call it here for today. Not a ton of forward progress. We made some, though. We got the spider ball and the power bomb. We definitely made some solid lateral progress, kind of exploring out a little bit, opening up some shortcuts between the areas. Had a great time. And we'll check you next time here at World 1-1 Podcast. Peace!